Flanders over here. She and I come from a Pentecostal background. There's one thing that I love in Scripture. When David talked about dancing before the Lord, one of those things with me is dancing in the Spirit. She said something in General Conference, my denomination, where she said, I like the church where if I want to dance, I can. Amen. Well, I've got to tell you about me. When I first came out of the closet, I want you to do something first. Give all these musicians a great big hand. You know how you can do a little background music. Amen. It's all right. I couldn't believe him. I'm thinking, my God, he can play anything. I'm listening to this. And I was just amazed when I heard you, young man. But I want to tell you something. When I first came out, oh my goodness, I tried to figure out how do you meet gay men? Amen. You know, that's every gay man is where do you meet other people like you? Amen. And I remember going to a bar in Hollywood. It was called the Red Raven. And it scared me to death. I mean, it was so dark in that bar and there were like hundreds of people, but they had signs all over the wall. Don't talk to strangers. And I thought, I didn't meet anybody. Amen. And later I asked somebody, I said, where do you meet men at? And they said, the best way is a gay dance bar. I thought, oh no. I said, I'm a Pentecostal. I said, I have never danced in my life. I said, what am I going to do? And so I decided I'm going to take some dance lessons. And of course, back then it was so simple. I took three little dance lessons. All you did was sit there and do this. You know, it's called the twist back then. And here we were for you who were from my generation. And I took those little dance lessons. I went to my first little gay bar. It was a wonderful dance bar. When I got there, I was freaked out of my mind. I'm thinking, oh Lord, I said, I just can't dance like these people. But somebody came over and asked me to dance, and I did a great job, and I thought, well, this is all right. Next week, I asked somebody to dance with me, had a wonderful time. I thought, I'm getting the pull of this. This is all right. Third week, you know, I go in, by now, I'm just dancing all over the place. Now, there was a dancer there that the crowd would open up and let him dance by himself. He was so good at what he did. Gorgeous African-American man, best dancer in the bar. And I found out he was a professional. He was a choreographer. Am I saying it right? Teaching dance. Yeah. And it was so funny. You know, I am there and I'm having a good time. I'm dancing away with a guy. And all at once, I see him looking at me. And I thought, oh my God, I must look good tonight. You know what I mean? He is looking at me, you know. And he was. And he started dancing through the crowd. And my goodness gracious, it wasn't long before he got up by me, leaned over and whispered in my ear and said, you've been around too many Pentecostal churches. God. I was in that the March on Washington, one of our marches, and I always go to our church in Washington, D.C., and I have to pray for me, amen. Before I get up on that stage, every one of them, I'm going to the Washington church, the early service, they laid hands on me, they prayed for me, and I then go and speak, and oh my goodness, at this particular service, though, something happened all at once. It was move the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, as we call it, amen. Dancing in the Spirit, something I hadn't done in MCC very often. And my partner, Philip, is there with me. And honey, when we got out of church, he said to me, you embarrass me. He said, you embarrass me. Now, he comes from a Southern Baptist church, white Southern Baptist, where they don't shout. I know the difference. Amen. He said, maybe I'm not using the right word, but I've never seen you act like that. I said, honey, I want to tell you the story of David. How David, when they brought the Ark of the Covenant in the city of Jerusalem, the Word of God said, not only did he dance, but I said he took up all of his clothes. I said, dancing in the Spirit. He danced the Ark of the Covenant in, hoping he would get to build the temple. Now, we all know that it was Solomon who built the temple. But David, you know, he danced. Now, when he got home, I told Philip, I said, his wife said to him, you have embarrassed me. You are the king of Israel. I said, I got to tell you something. I said, David got out and his wife jumped on him and said, you're the king of Israel. You've shown your nakedness to the nation. Said, here you are dancing. You were not doing it right. You were not sophisticated the way you were supposed to be. And I said, honey, at least I kept my clothes on. We had revival. Amen. I remember once preaching as a teenage evangelist, went to Wetumpka, Alabama. This is not the birthplace of gay liberation. Amen. But as a teenager, I went there and I preached in the Church of God. They couldn't get over it. In 3 weeks, we had a wonderful time. God moved. It was so boring at first. I kept praying, God, give us a breakthrough. And all at once, someone showed up at church. A woman that everybody knew who sat in a wheelchair selling pencils downtown. And I said, what are you here for tonight, sister? She said, I'm here for a healing. I said, then we're going to pray for you right now. And I prayed for her. The woman got up out of the wheelchair. Amen. Everybody in that little town. Honey, we couldn't keep people out of the church after that. I baptized 147 people during those 3 weeks that I was there. That's when everybody talked about baptism. But it was incredible as a child, as a teenager, to see God anoint and bless. Amen. But I've got to tell you something. Either our salvation gives us joy or it doesn't. If it doesn't give you joy, then you don't have salvation. Amen. You're in the wrong place. Amen. Joy of your salvation. Amen. So I'm going to tell you tonight before I lose my voice, I want to thank God for what God does. You know, every time we pray, I believe God moves. Yeah. And I remember years ago, and some of you have heard me tell this story, going to Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm going to quit with this. Atlanta, where somebody had tried to burn down our church 3 times in 1 week. $50,000 worth of damage to artwork on the walls. And I want to tell you, when I got there, everybody was just so upset. You could cut it, the tension, with a knife. And the Atlanta Constitution and an editorial said, where are the police? This is Atlanta. You know, we're not going to treat people like this. Where are the police? Well, Sunday morning rolled around. The TV cameras were all in front of our church. And we held a press conference. Jimmy, Brock, and I, you know, out in front of the church. The pastor at that time. And then he, you know, we walked in. And the pastor said, Troy, open with prayer. And I got up and I prayed, oh, God, send angels this morning. We need angels to surround this building. I said, we need angels here, Lord. Help us, oh, God. Well, we went on, we sung our first hymn, and then the usher on the second hymn. Wait for Jimmy and I to come to the back. We went to the back, and there was a woman standing there. Close-cut hair, combat boots, military fatigues, a black t-shirt, no bra, I could tell. And she said, Reverend Perry, she said, I'm the president of Alpha, the Atlanta Feminist Alliance, she said here, she said association, she said, the women in my group don't go to church, but I want to tell you what we've done. She said, I brought 40 dykes with me this morning. They have surrounded your building. Ain't nobody gonna bother you this morning.